has no right to tell a woman when and where to create one. So will the real men get up? I know you're fed up, ladies, but keep your head up.
All right, all right. Welcome. Welcome, everybody at Meerkat. Welcome. All right, all right. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, NASCAR Inc. NASCAR Inc. for restreaming. Thank you very much. We'll get started here in a minute or so. Less than a minute. 30 seconds and counting, ladies and gentlemen. Lion King, welcome, welcome. Lion King, welcome. All right, Periscope, show some love, hit the screen. Show some love, hit the screen. Good morning. Hit the screen and share. All right, hit the screen and share. This is not your first time, you know, we deliver the goods. Thank you, Lion King, for sharing. Sharing, thank you. All right, invite you to share on Twitter, share on Facebook. You do the same thing over there. Meerkat, share. Welcome, Living Chic. I see you, Living Chic. Appreciate you. Thank you very much. Thank you for sharing. E-La Prize, is that how you pronounce it? Put your name in there. Put your name in there. Welcome, welcome, welcome to today's scope. Jamming off a little Tupac. Keep your head up, keep your head up. Alright, alright, gotta get that blood flowing, ladies and gentlemen, gotta get that blood flowing. Welcome, 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 20 minutes, we're gonna cover this in 20 minutes, so you can get what you need from me. Go ahead and make it happen, it's 2 minutes after, let's go ahead and get it started. Let me turn off. Go ahead and check out Tupac a little bit later on your own, ladies and gentlemen. Alright, there's Periscope. Meerkat over there. All right, good morning, everybody. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Daryl Muhammad here, real estate investor, mentor, trainer, coach. Hey, hey, how you doing, Slow Mac, TK? Welcome, you guys, welcome. Just want to, you know, touch on wholesaling real quick, touch on some of the issues that pop up, some of the questions you have. Just kind of clear the picture, all right? There's power in clarity. All right, there's power and clarity. My name on Blab is Daryl Muhammad. I'm Daryl Muhammad on all the platforms, ladies and gentlemen. I have a fan page on Facebook, Daryl Muhammad on Twitter. All right, and I'll give you that information later. So we're excited to come at you today once again, giving you something that I've ran across in my 30 years of studying real estate and what now 15 years of being a real estate investor. Want to kind of help you go to the next level, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go together to the next level, all right? And this is a pre-launch. Let me pull my course out here. This is a pre-launch to a course that I'm coming out here pretty soon, within the next month or so, The Secrets to Wholesaling Real Estate Volume 1 and 2, 13 hours of boot camp style, how to make $5,000 a month with no credit, no cash, no risk, all right? To get on the VIP list, go to The Secrets to wholesaling.com. The secrets to wholesaling.com for those visual people. All right. The secrets to wholesaling.com. The secrets to wholesaling.com. You get on the VIP list. You'll find out more about the 13-day free training series that we're going to start here in the next week or so. And that's the list you want to be on, ladies and gentlemen, to find out about the launch and also to get the course. If you want to go ahead and get it early, all right, you can get a bootleg copy of my course. And it's downloadable, by the way. It's not a physical copy. A bootleg copy of my course. Go ahead and, reach out to me, okay? All right, so today we're going to talk about why wholesaling real estate is recession-proof. Ladies and gentlemen, you want to invest in things that are recession-proof. I learned this as a stockbroker back in 96. That you want to invest in things that are recession-proof, meaning that recession does not affect their value as much as other investments, okay? Now, let's clear some words here. Let's see what recession means. According to the dictionary, recession is a temporary decline in economic activity or prosperity, rescinding or withdrawal from a place or point, okay? All right, so that's recession, right? So when the economy contracts, gets smaller, meaning the flow and activity, economic activity gets smaller, okay? That's recession. Now, in the stockbroker world, right, there's a definition that's more scientific for trading. But for most of us, it just means that. The restriction or constriction of economic activity. So how is it, Daryl, that wholesaling real estate is recession-proof? I notice you didn't say real estate is recession-proof. You said wholesaling real estate is recession-proof, right? So that's what we're talking about today, because you need to know why it's recession-proof. You need to know why you need to make real estate, starting with wholesaling real estate, the cornerstone of your investment portfolio, all right? Real estate as a basis, right, of your investment portfolio. Make that the nucleus, all right? I know you have 401k plans, or you're investing in the market, you're on, you know, your auto pay on your mutual funds, $50 a month with Fidelity or whatever the case may be, right? But make real estate the center. You can make it the center later. You can replace the nucleus of your investment portfolio. Hey, Salmon, investment portfolio should be real estate, and it's not your house, all right? I believe what Robert Kiyosaki says, that your home is not an asset for you. It's an asset for your bank, all right? We'll get into more of that later, all right? So we're talking about, ladies and gentlemen, if you're just joining me or you're on the replay, go ahead. You still can hit the screen for hearts. If you're on the replay, you swipe to the right on Apple from the bottom on Android and share it, all right? Share it with your friends on Facebook and Twitter and follow me, all right? We're excited about the release of my course and the 13-day training series that we're going to have here coming up in a couple of days as a pre-launch to my course. A little bit more about that later. But here's what you need to understand about why wholesaling real estate is recession-proof. Number one, because it's real estate, ladies and gentlemen. Not just real estate, because there's many types of real estate, raw land, commercial, you know, minerals and all that kind of stuff. But we're talking about the thing that's common to all of us, residential real estate, residential real estate. Okay. Number one reason why it's recession proof is because wholesaling is in the residential real estate space of the big circle of real estate. Everybody has to have somewhere to live. So no matter how bad the economy gets, they have to have somewhere to live. All right? That's a necessity to life, is shelter. Food, shelter, and clothing. All right? So number one reason why, because it's residential real estate. Residential real estate. Okay? And what I learned as a stockbroker is that real estate, right? Real estate is the backbone of our economy. Real estate is second to jobs. Without a job, you can't pay rent. Without a job, you can't buy a home, right? So the second biggest stimulant in our economy here in the United States, the second largest is real estate, second to a job, all right? The number one generator that provides cash to circulate through a free enterprise system, a capitalistic system. You have to have a source of generating income. It's called the job. Okay? Job. Generally speaking, there's people on subsidy programs and all that kind of stuff. But generally speaking, a job, ladies and gentlemen. And then the second biggest is a home. Somewhere to live, then food, then some other things. But second is home. And why do I say this? And some of you might well say, what about food? Well, here's the thing. Real estate, right, makes up two-thirds of our economy. Real estate meaning real estate in those things that are ancillary to real estate, things that are attached to real estate, right? Things that are affected by real estate. We're talking about all real estate, commercial and residential alike, okay? So real estate, right, makes up two-thirds of the economy, that which is related to real estate, right? Go do your research. I learned this as a stockbroker. So it causes TVs to be bought, causes refrigerators to be bought, right? Causes cars to be bought, cause every, you know, a lot of these other, you know, industries are stimulated. Talking about stimulated, recession, stimulated by real estate, right? Residential and commercial, but primarily real estate, right? When Walmart moves into a new area and brings jobs, they bring people, real estate spikes, right? Real estate rental spikes, right? When Microsoft moves into another area or Apple moves into another area and brings in jobs, right, of a higher, you know, income level than maybe Walmart, right, brings in people, brings in jobs, right, stimulates the economy, people buy homes, right, then they buy furniture, right, then they have to buy school supplies for their children, they're buying TVs, now they're going out because they're present, they're going out in the area, okay, they're going out in society spending money because they're there. Right? They're buying blenders. I mean, it just goes on and on and on, all right? So just trust me on that. Two-thirds. So number one, real estate, residential real estate, because it makes up two-thirds of the economy, right? Two-thirds of the economy is affected directly or indirectly by real estate, okay? So that's it. So the other thing about residential real estate, okay, and I mention it because people always have to have somewhere to live. Now it shifts many times from, you know, home ownership spiking up, right? And rental leveling down, rental income, rental units are going down a little bit, right? But rental has gone up, right? The rental market has gone up. Rents have gone up. Why? Because all the people that got washed out of the home ownership market, the home ownership space in 2008, 2009, and haven't gotten back in. They don't want to get back in. They're scared to get back in, right? They can't qualify now because of their financial statement, if you will, foreclosures and late payments from 2009. You got it? Some things on there 5 years, 7 years, 10 years. So it's going to take them some time to get back into the home ownership market, all right? So because it's residential, because it makes up two-thirds of the local economy. That's number one. That's number one. Now, number two reason why wholesale and real estate is recession proof is because, like I said before, because it's wholesaling. It's not retailing, it's wholesaling. You're purchasing the property 50% of after repair or market value or greater. 50%, 60%, 70% of its value, below its value when fixed up and back on the market. So you're buying it with so much spread, ladies and gentlemen, to whereas when the economy shrinks or the activity, economic activity slows down, money doesn't go anywhere. The circulation of money slows down. Okay? But the money is still in the economy. And that's why you have to understand these dynamics. It's still in the economy. It might be sitting on the sideline in the banks. We called it sitting on the sideline when I was a stock market, right? The money is sitting on the sideline. They've taken it out of the market and put it on the sideline looking for a good investment. Investors are always looking for a good investment, and they know during recession time is when they really need to look, because that's when they can buy it substantially below value. And when the market picks up, they're already in position to profit. One of the formulas I learned back in the 80s when I started studying real estate investment, they say you make your profit in real estate when you buy, but you realize your profit when you sell. Let me say it again. You make your profit when you buy, meaning you're buying it at a good price, but you don't realize it until you sell, all right, or refinance. Till you cash out, pull the cash out of the property by selling or refinancing. So wholesaling is another way to make is recession proof, because you're buying it so substantially below market value. All right, you say, well, Darryl, what happened if it gets so bad? Okay, and I used to have to address that when I was a stockbroker. What happened if the stock market crashed like 1930? And I used to say, well, do you believe that'll happen? All right, well, let's put together a strategy and plan in place. Put a plan in place in case it crashes like you say it's going to crash. All right, but here's the thing. If you buy it cheap enough, you can always find someone else to sell it to. Right? So the key is during a recession, right, or money is tight, they call it, is for you to be better at what you do as a wholesaler than anybody else. Is for you and I to be able to find deals at a price that's so ridiculously cheap that we'll pull money, we'll find money and pull it off of the sidelines, right? And get it active again by us selling them these wholesale deals. When the market is hot, you need little. You know what I'm saying? You might can find a property and wholesale it at, I don't know, let's say 40% below after repair value. We're going to go into some terms maybe tomorrow. But ARV, right? Because money is just flowing. People just want to get in. I mean, they're getting money real cheap. They're getting free money. They don't want to get left out of the frenzy, right? All of that, you know, activities creating excitement, right? So they get in, right? That's what happened in California. Drove the market way up. And so when things blow up, they explode, implode, like the tech, you know, time when I was in the stock market, stock broker, you know, the tech bubble. See, it becomes a bubble because people keep on blowing air in it. And sooner or later it bursts, okay? So we have to just buy it at the right price. Buy it good enough to where it's a no-brainer. It's a no-brainer because everybody has to have somewhere to live. And if you make it cheap enough, you can find somebody to buy it. They can find somebody to sell it to. They can find somebody to rent it out. Well, you say, Daryl, but they're not loaning any money on home purchases. Yeah, they're not loaning any money on home purchases. Right? So that's a rental market. So yes, those investors that want to buy and sell, they have to be better skilled. Right? They have to be a better investor. They have to be better at what they do. They have to understand what to do, how to position themselves to sell a house in a recession, right? So homes are still sold during a recession, ladies and gentlemen. It doesn't go from thousands of homes, hundreds of thousands of homes a month being sold in America to zero. It never goes to zero, right? So you just need to be good enough to be one of those that be able to sell your home in a recession, all right? But we're talking about why wholesaling real estate is recession-proof, all right? If you're just joining us, my name is Daryl Muhammad, real estate investor, mentor, coach. Just coming on here every day of the week to share with you some things that I've learned in my 30 years of learning, right? Studying real estate investing, going to all the seminars that I can go to, and I still go to them to keep up with what's in the market, what's going on. All right. And since I started being a professional real estate investor in 2000, here's the course that I'm coming out with here in the next couple of weeks. It's going to be downloadable. All right. Not a physical copy. 13 hours boot camp style. How to make $5,000 per month with no job, no risk and no money. No job, no risk, no credit, no money. Just a strong desire and the right steps to get it done. All right, so we're going to come out with that. If you want more information, go to The Secrets to Wholesaling. Where's my little sheet here? TheSecretsToWholesaling.com. TheSecretsToWholesaling.com. You get on my VIP list, we'll send you an initial email, and then we'll keep you abreast about on our up and coming 13 days of nothing but nonstop boot camp style training. We're going to do 13 days. I'm going to pull a nugget from each one of the audio modules and share with you so you can take it, go out there and see that it works even before you get my course. Okay? So ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about why wholesaling real estate is recession proof. Talk about number one. Make sure you're taking notes. All right? Over there at Meerkat, come over to Periscope and watch the replay. It'll be up for 24 hours. But here's number one. Hopefully you're writing this down, all right? Because this is not entertainment. All right? Number one, residential real estate. It's residential real estate, right? Residential real estate or real estate as a whole makes up two-thirds of the U.S. economy. Two-thirds of the U.S. economy is affected by, directly or indirectly by, real estate. Buy real estate, right? Even your insurance cost is determined by where you live. Real estate, all right? Real estate. Two-thirds of the economy is affected by real estate, directly or indirectly, right? So that helps makes it recession-proof, right? Because it's such a major part of it, it's such an integral part of it, especially the residential piece. Everybody has to have somewhere to live. If not a home, an apartment, not by themselves with other people, right? So residential real estate, all right? And then we said number two is residential number is part of number one, and then two-thirds of the economy, all right? Residential real estate. Number two, because wholesaling, okay? Wholesaling is buying the property at substantially below ARV or market value. Substantially, really below ARV, not market value, ARV, right? So substantially below, 50% or greater below after repair value. So you're buying it so cheap. So as the economy contracts and gets smaller, then you have to buy it, you know, at a greater and greater and greater and greater and greater discount, right? Greater and greater and greater. So when the economy is booming, you might can wholesale at 40%. It tightens up, now you got to wholesale getting it at 50% below value. If it tightens up more, you got to get it at 55, 60% below after repair value. It tightens up some more, 70%, right? If not, they'll just have to hold it. Hey, Kevin, Godfrey, thank you for restreaming. I appreciate you. All right. So that's what we have to understand. We have to understand the dynamics, because what happens if not, then we make mistakes going in. Right. And then we become the motivated seller. And then a professional like myself will come in. Thank you for sharing, Sammy. Then a professional like me will come and relieve you of your burden, because you became that which you help people from, being a motivated seller. Okay, so number two, number one is residential real estate. Number two reason why wholesaling in particular, wholesaling real estate is recession proof, because you're getting it at a better price point, right? And the tighter the economy is, the more you have to get a bigger and bigger and bigger discount from after repair value. Because it doesn't matter how bad the economy gets, ladies and gentlemen, professional investors, people with money, people who have a lot of money, people who understand, thanks for sharing, Sammy, people who understand what's going on, they're always looking for some place to put their money. They hate that their money is sitting in a bank. Well, they probably don't put it in a bank. I learned as a stockbroker, they don't put it in a bank. They put it in a money market account at a brokerage firm that they can write checks off of. They can use as a credit. They can use as a debit card and pull their money and have it freely accessed. And they are getting 2-3 points, they call it. 2-3 points compared to a savings account, right? Savings account, checking account, the money's tied up. They're getting 1% at most right now. So they might as well put in the money market account at a brokerage firm, right? And get 4%, 5%. But they hate that, right? They hate that. You know, they hate that. See, this is my stockbroker experience, ladies and gentlemen, right? So they hate that. So I'm trying to help you to understand, because, see, when you don't know what you don't know. And then then we're more, yeah, but. And the yeah, but is because we don't know. It's because our level of ignorance. So I'm trying to help you to understand that when you buy it cheap enough, ladies and gentlemen, you can always find an investor. You can always find an investor. Money comes from around the world to America, especially in real estate, from around the world looking for places to park their money that's better than the stock market, that's better than money market accounts, right? And international investors know that real estate is always the safest place. Brick and mortar, something that you can knock on the doors and say, well, that's my investment, right? You can't do that with a stock, mutual funds. Hey, David, mutual funds, right? Stocks. Most people don't even hold the shares of stocks that they own. It's just on a statement, right? So real estate, real, it's real. It's real estate. You can go and kick it, right? You can go and touch it, right? Hey, Cortez, how you doing? So, you know, these are the things we have to understand, ladies and gentlemen. These are the things that I want to help you to understand and shorten your learning curve. See, a lot of times people don't take action because the gradient scale is too steep. The learning scale is too... Hey, if you like it, that's right. Show some love. Show some hearts, ladies. Heart me up. Give me a heart attack. I need a heart attack over here. All right? Give me some love. If you're getting any value, you know, then exchange, right? That's how I know you're there. That's how I know you're not falling off. That's how I know that my connection is still here with you guys. Go ahead and get some hearts and respond. Lady Sheik, let me know you're out there. Ask some questions. Kevin Godfrey, appreciate you restreaming. Let me know you're out there. Ask some questions. Is this making any sense? Do we have any real estate professionals out there? Realtors. Hey, Kevin, Kelly, have any real estate investors out there? We have any real estate agents? We're one big happy community. We're not in competition with each other. All right. So if you're doing a real estate, you're in real estate investing, you're a real estate agent, give me a call. Let's connect. All right. This place is huge. Right. 6,000 square miles is America. There's a lot of real estate out here. We do better together than we do apart. Right. That's the reason for my course. There's two objectives I'm going to achieve in my course. One, to give you a tool that you can use. Right. To better prepare yourself, which all of us who are students of the economy knows that this thing is going to get bad and real bad real soon. It's going to be like we've never seen it before. And those that are best prepared will survive. Those who are not best prepared will not survive. Okay? So that's my contribution back to the real estate wholesaling space that I was blessed to be able to learn from. And my family has never been the same since. And I'll tell you a little bit about my story a little bit later, right? That's number one. Number two is to find the best students that are out there so we can partner. We can partner. You can do more together than what you can do by yourself. I heard one of my mentors say, and I don't remember who it is. I claim all folks as my mentor that got good stuff. Hey, Dr. Renee. They said, if your goal that you have is big enough for you to achieve by yourself, then your goal is not big enough. All right, this is the motivation piece. We'll cover that on another Periscope. If your goal is big enough for you to achieve by yourself, then your goal is not big enough. All right? So that's the reason for my course, those two things. You need to get it. Go to The Secrets to Wholesaling. Here it is again for those just joining. TheSecretsToWholesaling.com, ladies and gentlemen. Coming out with my own course, and it's for those two reasons. It's not to get rich. You get rich in real estate. You don't get rich in selling courses. Right? All right? You only do that to reach people, to find people, to help people. All right. So those are the reasons why wholesaling real estate is recession proof. Hey, Kelly Dukes, is recession proof, ladies and gentlemen. One, because it's real estate and it's residential real estate, right? It makes up 2/3 of the economy. The economy, 2/3 of the economy is directly, indirectly affected by residential real estate and real estate in general, right? And then the other part of that, to number one is, that it's residential real estate. It's residential, not commercial, right? Because people go out of business during a recession, right? They downsize in space during a recession. So it's residential real estate, all right? Number two is because it's wholesaling. It's wholesaling. You're buying it at a substantially below market price. And the tighter the economy, the bigger the discount has to be. Below ARV. After the repair value. How much is this property worth after it's been fixed up? All right? After repair value, not market value. Market value is how much you can get for it as it is right now, the condition of the property right now on the market. If it needs $50,000 worth of repairs, then its market value is subtracted by $50,000. Right? It's the after repair value minus the repair cost. That's what it's worth right now. That's market value. We're not talking about market value and wholesaling. We're talking about after repair value. What is this property worth after it's been fixed up? And we'll get into more of that during the 13-day training series that we're going to have here on Periscope within the next week or so. All right? All right? So hopefully that helped, ladies and gentlemen. That's why you and I and all of us need to have understand why wholesaling real estate is recession proof. All right, now here's how you can reach me. All right, Twitter, Can you see that? I'm a little too close on. All right, so Twitter, there, Periscope, my name. Twitter, my name, right? What else? Facebook fan page is Daryl Muhammad. Fan page. All right. If you have some questions about what I covered in any of these Periscopes, if you want to get my course, I'll bootleg you a copy. All right. Thank you very much, Cortez. Call that number, 713-817-5952, and leave me a message. Right. If I don't recognize the number, I don't answer it, you know, even when I'm not busy. Right. Leave me a message. Leave me your number one most pressing question, real estate question. Okay. Real estate question, your name, your contact, and your experience of real estate, your experience of in real estate, your experience of real estate, all right? So there you go, Meerkats, that's my number. Call me. I'll be able to provide you with some free help, some free advice. You know, I don't know it all, but I believe if I don't know it, I can point you in the right direction. If I don't know it, I'll tell you I don't know, right? I'm not a guru. I'm just an experienced, successful wholesale and real estate investor. All right, that'll save you some time, cut you through all the BS, okay? So that's what we're looking at, ladies and gentlemen. All right, that's how you can contact me. Give me a call, because once I release my course, we're looking at the third week of November, then, of course, my time will have to go to my paid clients or my paid students, okay? But right now, excuse me, I'll help you for free. Call that number, 713-817-5952. Leave me just one question, your most pressing question, the question that will give you the breakthrough to take the next step, right? The next step towards taking action. Leave your name and your question, your name and your level of experience, level of real estate experience. Waiting to hear from you, Living Chic, waiting to hear from you, all right? I'm here to network, so if you're a real estate professional, all right, that means a real estate agent, a realtor, okay, or a real estate investor, reach out to me. Let's network, all right? I help you, you help me, because there's enough for all of us to eat. There is no lack in the universe. There is no lack. God has no lack, all right? God is never in a recession, right? God is never in a recession. So that's the website to get on my VIP list, thesecretstowholesaling.com. It's all together. Just space it out like that so you can read it, and I can get it on this paper. The Secrets to Wholesaling Realestate.com, ladies and gentlemen, it's been a pleasure. Happy to be with you. Thank you, Sammy. Appreciate you. There is no lack in God's universe. All right? So if there's a lack, there's only a lack in our thinking. There's only a lack in our actions. Right? There's only a lack in our faith and our belief and our understanding. Right? We cover all of that in my training program. The number one, thank you. The number one, the first CD. Right? The first CD in this course, we don't get into techniques and don't get into make, you know, $100,000 your first year part-time and all that stuff. Not the first CD. We do get into that, but not the first CD. The first module, I should say, because it's downloadable audio. You can get it today. Just reach out to me. I'll bootleg you a copy. I'll bootleg you a copy. I'll get you a bootlegged copy of my course if you want it now. Right? If you want it now. So the first CD is, the first audio, I should say, the first module, I should say, all right, is Success is a Mindset. Success is a mindset, right? I've been in network marketing for years and years and years, and people hop from company to company, but you know the problem with that is, and they don't reach any level of major success, but they hop from company to company, right? The greatest products and sliced bread. But the problem is, you know, the problem is you bring you with that new opportunity, right? So the opportunity doesn't make you, you make the opportunity. So it doesn't matter if it's my course, Robert Kiyosaki's course, Nick Verducci's course. It doesn't matter whose course it is. You're going to make what they give you, what they share with you. You're going to make it work for you and make it successful for you or not. All right. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so very much. If you have any questions, 713-817-5952. Reach out to me. Leave me a message. Your number one pressing question, your name, your level of real estate experience, those real estate professionals, investors, reach out to me. You give me your number. I'll reach out to you. Reach out to me. Let's do something together. A Periscope, a Blab. Let's expand. Let's expand. Robert, Grant Cardone says when the economy shrinks, you expand. Focus on expanding. Thank you, Sammy. I appreciate you. And as always, ladies and gentlemen, we'll see you at the top, not from the top, because you, your family, but most important, your community, the one you live in, right? The one you love the most, deserves your very best.